teachers, because you'll be required to keep a record of all that you are learning from day one all the way to the end of the course. Therefore, you need a tool that will help you to be able to keep the record. And because we are learning about ICT, we have to use technology in order to be able to keep our record. We are not going to use a pen or a paper to write the record of all that we are learning. Therefore, we are going to introduce you to Google Documents, which will be an online document that you'll be able to use all the time when you're keeping record of all that you're learning. Therefore, Google Document will be created. You will create a Google Document, you will give it a name, and then you'll be able to keep record of day one, the activities, what you're learning, how you can be able to apply in your teaching learning, and what is the new knowledge you're gaining in the process. Likewise for day two, day three, all the way to the end. And therefore, to be able to do that, you need to have a Gmail account. So you have to have a Gmail account to be able to log in to your Gmail. And then from there, you have to go to the applications as listed. But to do how you do that, the following will be the steps or the procedures that you have to follow.
To create your Google document for storing or starting your course journal, you need first of all to have a Gmail account, log in into your account and be able to see that you have logged in. Now I see that Tema Shuren is active. And then you can also be able to see your emails. These are all your emails that come up. And then you can see your inbox and all other parts. But then once you're in your inbox, click on the applications, this part here, where you have all the applications opening up. And then you click on the Drive. These are many applications that Google gives you as free. You can be able to use your Gmail, your YouTube, your Play Store, your contacts, your Drive, your calendar, your Google Drive, Google Plus, your photos. But in this case, we're going to deal only with Google Drive. So some other applications may come up later when we go on through the course. But now we'll go to Google Drive. So click on Google Drive and you see that Google Drive will be opening up. So this is the Google Drive of which we need to create our Google document where we'll be able to store the activities that we do every day. And remember, when we store these activities in the unknown environment, these will be always available in the environment and it is something that is stored in the cloud. And therefore, anytime you log into your account, wherever you are, you'll be able to access all the resources. So once you click on, you open up your Google Drive, you'll see that you have Drive opening up and you have so many options here coming up. So this is the Drive part, the computer, your computer part. So all the drives you are shared with will be here and all the recent activities you do. Now we have to create one document, Google Document. Click either here, you'll see this Google Docs as the point where you have to come from, or click on New, this part of New where you have also Google Docs. So click on this Google Doc, it shows you that this is a Word document, this is an Excel document, and this is a Google Slide. Now for this case, we're not going to deal with these two. We are also only going to deal with Google Documents. Remember, however, you can also be able to create a new folder. You can also be able to upload all your files. You have your certificates, your documents, which you need to store in the cloud. You can also be able to upload a file, a folder complete, a big folder. But in this case, we're only discussing on Google Documents. So click on Google Documents. Now a plain document will be opening up. So this is a document which we have to be able to save and be able to work on. This will be our journal that we'll be using whenever we are creating, we are writing or keeping a record of all that we are learning day by day. So on day one, day two, day three, day four, all the way to the end. So you have to write what you are learning in this course in this on this day. I learned about XYZ and I'm going to apply this in my setting in XYZ. So in the first place, what you do when you open up this Google document, you have to rename the document. Give the name or name to this document. So now here you see it, the name is ICT Journal Course. So just type in and start typing your name. And then give names as you see here down. So ICT Course Journal June 15 to 28 this March. And day one, then the module of the day is Motivation to Use Technology in Teaching and Learning. So what I learned, write down all what you have learned here. Just you have to type down all that you have learned. And then you could be able to write the knowledge gained. What have you gained from this module? And then, of course, you could be able to see, you write something on how you're going to apply this setting of knowledge in your classroom, in your setting or in classroom. When you finish writing about day one, this will be all for day one. And then for day two, again, you start day two, the date of the day and the topic of the day, which is module two, hardware tools. Then you do the same for that. So generally, you'll be able to keep a record of all that you have been able to learn from day one when the course started all the way to the last day when the course comes to an end.